Now, the new normal is usually referred to wearing a mask, following SOPs like scanning before you enter anywhere, hand sanitizing, and you guys know the rest. But there's also another new normal, which is something that all of us are very used to for the past 2 years or so, which is the term work from home or WFH. So with that, if you think that it's time for you to upgrade from your super jaded screen tablet or your dusty old laptop, well, Huawei has released not one, but two devices to make your work from home situation extra productive. So keep watching. Firstly, let's look at Huawei's brand new tablet, the Huawei MatePad 11, and what I personally like about it. So remember I said about how you should upgrade from your old jaded screen tablet? Well, the Huawei MatePad 11 comes with an extremely smooth 120Hz refresh rate and a great 10.95-inch Huawei Full View display. And with this, you'll experience a very fluid navigation, whether or not it's web page browsing, multitasking, zooming in and out for various content, even if you want to play videos or even games as well. And what's extra sweet is that since it has an 86% screen-to-body ratio with slim bezels, you'll have a very consistent and immersive viewing experience, especially with a DCI P3 color gamut. And if you're bound to hours and hours of working and staring at the tablet for a very long time, the good news is that it has the double TUV rain lens certified with low blue light and flicker-free hardware technology, making it easier on your eyes, thus not causing any eye fatigue or damaging your eyes. So yes guys, the screen of the tablet is surely one of the first cool factors about the MatePad 11. Next, as I've highlighted in my MatePad Pro video previously, the Huawei M Pencil Generation 2 is surely a godsend to make your life easier using it together with the MatePad 11 as well. So previously I've mentioned that the MatePad Pro 2021 comes with a new M Pencil 2. Well now, with the MatePad 11, it also uses the same M Pencil, which is now even better on the MatePad 11. Now this is because it has an extremely low lag of only 2 milliseconds and it has 4096 pressure and tilt sensitivity as well. So with that, I can't stress how extremely flawless the writing and drawing experience is when using the M Pencil 2 on the MatePad 11, although I am horrible at drawing. Now, additional features such as the double tap to switch tool are really handy to quickly switch between drawing to writing mode to eraser mode. And to further enhance the overall experience, the Huawei Free Script allows you to input text on any text field for a smoother and a natural input experience, not forgetting the built-in shortcuts to make handwriting input even more convenient, such as drawing on a horizontal line on a text to select a text, drawing a wavy line to delete a text, and drawing a vertical line to add or delete space between the characters. So yes, this proves that this M Pencil is just not your regular writing tool. Then finally, speaking of writing or drawing, other than writing notes on apps such as WPS Office or OneNote, using these apps with the M Pencil and the keyboard is just like a PC to me. The features on the M Pencil like Instant Shape and Instant Table are extremely handy for situations where if you want to create a quick shape or table. So wouldn't it totally suck if you had a tablet with poor battery life? Well, based on my usage, I found that the battery life on the MatePad 11 to be really impressive, where I got an average of 12 hours and sometimes even more during my usage daily just from a single charge, making it super handy to charge your tablet from work mode to just sitting back on your sofa and watching videos for a quick break and then going back to work. Now, if you're like me who prefer to watch videos on tablets without using headphones and just listening to the tablet speakers alone, here's where you'll really appreciate the speakers coming from the MatePad 11 as well. So the MatePad 11 comes with quad channel large amplitude quad speaker system together with a very much improved Houston 7.0 that gives a better overall volume, especially on the low end frequencies of the bass. And since the overall audio is tuned by the great guys at Harman Kardon, as an audiophile and a musician, I could really tell there was a lot that went into tuning in the sound, and here is a quick sound test.
Going all the way.
Next, to further enhance the audio department, I also found that the microphones on the tablet to be really great too, with the new normal of having virtually everything. With four microphones in total, three along the sides and one smartly placed at the rear camera module, the overall noise reduction and the echo cancellation features was very handy for online classes or online meetings as well. And here is another sound test on the microphone instead. Hey guys, Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV. Test 1-2, test 1-2, test 1-2. This is a microphone test. And finally, for you spec nerds out there, the MatePad 11 comes with a Snapdragon 865 chipset. Yep, this is the very first on a Huawei device. With the Adreno 650 GPU, 6GB of RAM, with two choices of storage, which is 128 or 256GB of storage, which both can be expanded to 1TB via the micro SD card slot. Then as for the software, it comes with Huawei's own Harmony OS 2. Next, look at the camera specs. It has a rear 13MP f1.8 aperture lens, and the front camera comes with an 8MP f2.0 lens. And for those of you who do not have a PC, who want to get a PC-like experience, you can always connect a mouse to the tablet or even the magnetic keyboard to have a similar workflow. And this would be especially very handy since you can download all your favorite desktop apps such as the Microsoft PowerPoint and Word, or even download games, which are all available at the Huawei App Gallery as well. So if you're a little old school or prefer to have a laptop experience, well, here's where I would advise for y'all to look into the new Huawei MateBook D15, and here is my personal favorite features. Now, starting from the build quality and the design, it is truly aesthetically pleasing, as you guys can see, and it truly cuts away from any unnecessary bulk on the laptop. It is only 1.56 kg light and 16.9 mm thin. So whether or not you're placing this on your lap or simply carrying it around, you'll find that this durable alloy slim body to be very handy. Then looking at the iOS or the ports available, the MateBook D15 has quite an impressive array of ports, so you don't have to live a dongle life. Where on the right, you'll find the 2-in-1 3.5mm earphones and the microphones jack, and two USB 2.0 ports. Then on the left, you'll find a USB-C port, a USB 3.2 generation 1 port, and a HDMI port. So again, it is nice that even though it comes with a really aesthetically looking design laptop, it does not compromise on really having the necessary ports for you students or even if your team work from home. Next, diving straight into the performance of the laptop, it consists of the variants of 10th generation Intel Core processor or the 11th gen Intel Core processor with 4 cores, 8-thread CPU, giving you great processing power alone for your regular work, coupled with an option of 8GB of RAM with either 512GB of NVMe SSD storage. It is surely great for simple video editing or casual gaming with the Intel Iris Xe graphics as well. Now, what's extra sweet is there was never a point in time where the bottom of the laptop became extremely hot to the touch, since it has Huawei's shark fin fan with a total of 2 heat pipes, which is great to know, especially with this kind of form factor as mentioned earlier. Now, like the MatePad 11, a really nice screen is surely a huge must, right? Well, fret not, my friends, because the MateBook D15 comes with a 15.6 inch FHD with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels with anti-glare properties. And like the MatePad 11, it also has the double TUV rain lens certified with low blue light and flicker free, making it easier on your eyes once again during a long usage. Now, the bezels on this are pretty narrow as well at 5.3 mm with a high 87% screen to body ratio, making the overall screen real estate to be nice and wide, especially with a 16:9 aspect ratio as well. So yes, the laptop could convert from being a workhorse to a great video content consumption machine, especially with the great audio experience. Okay, so what if you feel like, you know, you wanna marry these two devices together and let the devices work in tandem? Well, as you might or might not know, the Huawei ecosystem allows you to do that. Now, in addition to the multi-screen collaboration between your phone and the tablet, the new MatePad 11 supports a tablet to PC multi-screen collaboration, which, as the name suggests, it will allow you to connect the MatePad 11 to the MateBook D15 wirelessly. Now, there are three modes available for the tablet-PC multi-screen collaboration. Firstly, there's the mirror mode, where in this mode, the screen of the MateBook D15 will be mirrored to the tablet to show exactly the same content. And this also means that it will convert the MatePad 11 into a digital drawing pad together with the second generation M Pencil as mentioned earlier, making it easier when it comes to signing documents, adding comments on documents and many more. Then the second mode is called the Extend mode, and here's where the MatePad 11 becomes an additional or a secondary display for the MateBook D15 to obviously create more space to display your content. So this personally for me is one of my frequently used modes when I do simple video editing or writing my scripts to have the information on one screen and typing on the other. And the other idea that I have is to watch a video podcast on one device and the other to browse or taking notes. And the final mode is called the Collaborate mode. So remember the days where you will need to either email yourself a photo or a document in order to use it on your other device, or copying files on a thumb drive and then taking it and inserting on your second device? Well guys, I'm here to tell you that those days are gone. Because with this Collaborate mode, you can simply drag and drop files such as images, videos, documents and more in this mode as well. With this, it is super straightforward and of course saves tons of time compared to doing it in the traditional method as mentioned earlier. Alright guys, so those are my personal favorite things about the Huawei MatePad 11 and the Huawei MateBook D15. With the existence of these two devices, it will surely be a great way to boost your overall productivity, efficiency and the overall daily tasks, especially with the new normal of work from home. So depending on your budget, you might consider getting both because the Huawei MatePad 11's pricing is starting from RM1,999 and the MateBook D15 is starting at RM2,999 and is already available from the 27th of July onwards, where I'll leave links down below for you guys to make a purchase. So with this, which one of the favorite features that I've mentioned that you think would be beneficial for y'all as well? Do let me know in the comment section below, and also which one of these devices that you guys would consider getting, the MatePad 11 or the MateBook D15 or both. Aside from that, thank you so much for watching. My name is Adam Lobo and I'll catch you guys in my next video.